name is Chuck at Gardens Bot Acres. Thanks for coming along again today. Today we're going to be plumbing out our 5-barrel rainwater catchment system here. I've already plumbed 2 of these. We put the bulkhead fitting in. We've added a T. We have a plug at this end. A PVC 3/4-inch fitting here. Down here I have the same exact setup, except we have the 2 PVC fittings on each side. Now before we get going, you might have a question, why did I bother with a T here? I had an elbow first, but the elbows aren't the same depth as the T's. So in order to keep everything in line here, I had to go ahead and use a T with a plug on the end. So what we're going to do first here today, I'm going to show you how to go ahead and put a bulkhead fitting in without getting frustrated. And first of all, we're going to drill a hole right here. And that's going to be a 1 3/8-inch hole for the bulkhead fitting. And we have those over here. And I'll show you these parts in a minute. Okay, let me just go ahead and get that hole drilled. Then we'll look at the parts that we need to make a single rain barrel. Then I'll go ahead and gang these 5 together. GoPro, stop recording. All right, this is a bulkhead fitting. This goes through the back. It's got a nice thick washer here, rubber washer. And this will go on the front. And you tighten that on and it makes a waterproof seal. But to do that, we're gonna rig up a string with a weight on the end. I'm going to drop that down through the barrel top hole and fish it out the bottom. But before we do that, I'm just going to use a utility knife here. I don't want this string getting lost inside the barrel in case it falls. So I'm going to tie a utility knife on there to keep it from going down the hole. Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to drop that down and we'll fish it out the hole that we're going to drill out down here. Then I can drop my bulkhead fitting down the string and pull it out. Okay, let's see how that works. Okay, make sure my fitting goes through there. Yep, that's good. There are no burrs on the inside. I was gonna pull some of this plastic off. Man, this barrel's sticky. I've washed it out a few times. It had tapioca glucose in it. Man, sticky, gummy. Still got a little bit in the bottom. I'm putting these holes 6 inches off the bottom. I may run a drip irrigation system with these, and I don't want any sediment going through the drip lines. So I'm putting these well up off the bottom. And a second reason I'm going off the bottom so much is because these are facing the west. Get a lot of wind this way. And I want some weight in the bottom of these to keep these from shifting too much. even though I'm going to strap these down to the wall, I still want some weight in these. They're very light. All right, we're going to drop the weight down through the hole in the top. Fish in there with your finger, and there it is. Okay, pull that out. And I can put this up here to keep that from going down the hole, losing my string while I work here. Okay, I'm gonna feed this down through. Okay, like this. I want the threads facing down because I want to be able to pull this out the hole. Okay. Let me set that there. Let's put this back up here for now. All right. Okay. Let's drop that down. There we go. And just like that, we got it. Now these are left-handed threads, so you're gonna have to thread these on backwards. You can just hold it right here like this and get it started threading. Then reverse your hand, put your thumb inside. And tighten that down. I'm gonna grab a pair of water pumps. Now this is going to have to collapse your side a little bit here because this is curved. So you're going to keep tightening this until you have a flat spot here. And you don't want to strip your threads, that's all. There we go. So you have the bulkhead fitting in. Next thing we're going to do, gonna take this piece here and we'll thread that into there. But before I thread it, I'm gonna put some tape on it, just Teflon tape. You could use pipe dope, you know, the pipe joint compound. Okay, let's thread it on. Tape that. Now before I get going and I put my T on, I'm gonna grab a couple of these male adapters here. the other one. Okay, and we'll spin that on there. And we're ready to go for the next one. Now, if you're just going to do one tank, you would just have a fitting come out here. And you could put your valve on like this. And this is just fitting 3/4 down to a hose, down to a male hose fitting. So you can put a hose right on here. Now, if you're going to put a valve on, go with the 1/4-turn valves like these. Okay. You'll get more pressure than you will with a Silcock valve, you know, the ones you turn on. Okay. This is a 1/4-turn full pressure. And that's what you'll want. Okay, that would go on like that. Okay. So I'm gonna go ahead and get this next one done. Then we'll do one more down here on the end together. Right on this last one, I'm going to try using a hole saw. I didn't have a 1 3/8 inch hole saw, but I do have a 1.5, and that seems like that'll be work fine anyways. So I'm going to go ahead and use a hole saw and see how this works differently than a spade bit. Yeah, that works a little bit cleaner. Drop this through here. Remember, you want the string feeding through the part that comes out of your barrel. Okay, you want the gasket on the back side if you're using this type of bulkhead fitting. Got one rubber gasket on, not two. And pull that out. Yeah, you don't want that to fall in, especially if there's tapioca glucose in there. That's lovely stuff. There, no chance of losing it now. Thank you. And this is gonna flatten your barrel a little bit, and you're gonna have to do that in order to get a good seal. Let me get this one on this side first. You know what? I'm gonna wait on that because I can't have this on the wrong side when it's tight. So I'm gonna put that in last this time on the end. Ready? I think I like the handle. Yeah, that would be good. And what I've done here, I just have the fittings here. So we have a reducer here that's gonna go from 3/4 to 1/2 inch. Probably should have put all this together before I put it on there. All this part anyways. That way I wouldn't have to put so much pressure on this. Push them back to the wall. Like that. Now we're going to put our PVC in between here. Now all these I measured up from the bottom 6 inches. So every one of these centers is 6 inches. So that means these are all, I don't measure from the top because my barrels aren't the same. If yours are, it doesn't matter. So we're going to go ahead and put all these together now with the PVC. Then I'll have the gutter guy come in and put our gutters on. And we'll have a diverter down into here. Okay, we're all ready for our PVC connectors. Go ahead and make sure I have my barrels tucked into each other. There we go. Now the first one's gonna be I'll go 17 3/8. I'll try these ratcheting PVC cutters that I bought for the first time. So this one's gonna be 19 3/4. Thank you. 19 5/8. And I think I might do on this end down here, get a 2x4 block, come right down off the base from here and right up to here to support this one a little better, because it's going to have the most wear on it when I'm using the valve. So I might just support that a little bit. I'm also going to put an eye bolt in back here and one on the other side and strap this to the wall all the way around back to here. I think that'll secure that well, especially if you get water in them, they're not going to move anyways. Hey, thanks for coming along. Hope you enjoyed this little series on the water catchment system from the ground up. I'll put links at the end of the video so you can see other water catchment systems that I've done with the big 275 gallon totes. I'll also put a video link to the little portable cart that you saw me using that I built. Again, thanks for watching. Could you please share this with your friends and family? Share it on social media for me. And again, thanks a lot for watching. Have a great day. Bye-bye.